Hey everyone, it's Russell here for NDAX, and today we're going to be talking about one of my favorite features on the platform, and that is recurring purchases. And it's one of the best ways to get started investing in crypto, and it could save you thousands of dollars through a strategy called dollar cost averaging. So in this video, you'll learn exactly what dollar cost averaging is, how it can be so hugely beneficial for you, and how easy it is to set up on the NDAX platform. Let's first start with what dollar cost averaging is. Now, as I'm sure you know, any investment that you can buy can go up and down in value. Now, imagine you're getting started for the very first time and you have $1,000 to invest. So you head to NDAX and you buy a digital asset, something like Bitcoin. Awesome. But then you wake up the next day and you check the price of Bitcoin and you realize, oh no, it's gone down 10%. Of course, this isn't ideal, but it's not your fault. It's incredibly difficult to predict the short-term ups and downs of any cryptocurrency, but there is a strategy that you can use to help greatly reduce the risk of having a situation like this happen to you, and that strategy is called dollar cost averaging. Whereas before you spent your entire $1,000 on Bitcoin all at once, instead with dollar cost averaging, you could put $100 into Bitcoin each week over the course of 10 weeks. As a result, the price that you're paying for Bitcoin would be the average price over the course of those 10 weeks, hence the name dollar cost averaging. So if 1 week you buy $100 worth of Bitcoin, but then by the next week the price has gone down 10%, you won't be as upset because you can then continue to buy at this new lower price with the long-term idea that the price will go up over time. Now, NDAX makes this dollar cost averaging strategy so easy to do with a feature called recurring purchases. This lets you automate the entire process and means you don't even have to remember to log in to make your purchase each week. Let's hop on the NDAX platform so I can show you what I'm talking about. So here we are on the NDAX dashboard, and you can see on the left-hand bar, there's a section here that's called recurring purchases. When you click there, you're going to be able to see any previous recurring purchases or dollar cost averaging that you've set up. If you haven't yet set up any recurring purchases, you'll have a blank screen like this, but you can set up your first one by clicking this green add icon in the bottom right-hand corner. Now, when you do, a dialog is going to come up here where you can set up your recurring purchases in any way you'd like. You can name this recurring purchase or subscription anything you'd like. For this example, let's call it ETH weekly, and we'll set up the period or how frequently we want this purchase to happen right here. You can choose between daily, weekly, or monthly. We'll go with weekly. You can choose which day of the week you want. We'll go with Wednesday. And then what time of the day? 12 p.m. sounds good to me. And then here is where you indicate what exactly you want to be purchasing on a recurring basis. For this example, we're going to be doing ETH, and then we can set the amount. You can choose from some pre-filled options here, $100, $250, $500, or $1,000, or you can set up a custom amount. We're going to go with the $100 Canadian amount, and then it's simple. You can just click create, and then in your recurring purchases tab, you'll see this new recurring purchase or subscription set up, and inside of here, you can click on it and get all the information. Currently, it says this one's running every Wednesday at 12 p.m. at the amount of $100 Canadian, and you can see here via this icon that we'll be purchasing ETH on that weekly basis. Another way that you can set this up from the dashboard is by looking for this portfolio distribution section on your dashboard. You can click see all here, and then on the list of various assets that you can purchase on NDAX, there's this button right next to trade called DCA, and we now know that that's dollar cost averaging. So if we wanted to dollar cost average into Bitcoin, we could click this DCA button, and then these same sort of prompts would come up where you would be able to set up your strategy. So you can see just how easy NDAX makes it to set up these recurring purchases so you can dollar cost average, and I think it's one of the best ways to invest in cryptocurrency. Whether you're someone who has a lot of money and is looking to sort of average out their entry price into any digital asset, or if you're somebody who has less money right now and only wants to put in a certain amount per month, per week, or per day and slowly trickle into the markets, this strategy could be right for you. And if you want some more examples and even more information on exactly how dollar cost averaging works, you can check out the link in the description of this video that will take you to the NDAX blog article that goes into a lot more detail. But with all of that said, I hope you found this video on dollar cost averaging and recurring purchases using NDAX helpful. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll talk to you again soon.